Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Kevin, and this is Marcus. And welcome to NRT
Now.
Now. Right now. Streaming to you live from the NRT headquarters in Boise, Idaho.
I'm disappointed. That was your chance to lip sync battle me.
I don't know all these people. I don't know the lyrics.
Of this song?
I don't.
Anybody watching right now knows what song this is? Because it's one of the best. They even had a dance for this.
There you go. As much as I loved pop music, I loved mainstream pop music even more.
At that time.
Really? So while I do know all of this music, I was really into NSYNC, Britney Spears.
Yeah? Oh, I'll be right back. So, you keep talking.
Great. I love it when you do that. We are talking about best pop throwback music from back in the day. So it's Throwback Thursday. This is our second week that we are doing this, and we want to hear from all of you. What music from the pop genre have you listened to? We've got a list. We're going to be going through our favorites, but at any time, you can post what you want and distract us in our conversation.
Hey, we're doing throwback. We're doing throwback, and we've talked about this a few times on this program, but we used to both be in Christian retail.
Yes.
And I have my old name tag.
Yes.
And look, it says boy band expert. Right there. I was in the music department when Plus One came out. You know,
yep.
I became the boy band expert.
This was the years were 1999 to about 2005, 2006, somewhere around there.
Yeah, earlier it died off a little bit before that. It was like, I mean, Exodus, Plus One's Exodus, which
2003.
2003. Oh, by the way, the song we're listening to is Written on My Heart by Plus One.
There you go.
Where are you, people? I know there's a minute delay between when they. I learned this yesterday.
There's a minute delay.
Yeah, between when they write and when we see it.
Oh.
So there you go. So start typing stuff. Who's your favorite throwback pop groups in Christian music? We're talking about that today. That was one of my favorite songs, Written on My Heart by Plus One.
The great thing about Plus One is they got better as they progressed. Almost, I feel the same way about Backstreet Boys. Like, their artistry was really good. Their new albums in the past, like, maybe decade are actually almost better than when they first came out, but they also sold a lot less.
And they also, they didn't capture sort of the mainstream appeal that they had before. Plus One was put together by the same kinds of people. I know they were. It was an Orlando-based thing where they got all these guys from different corners of America. I think Nate Cole and Gabe Combs were buddies. They knew each other, but everybody else didn't know each other. They just smashed them together like they were doing at that time. Like, hey, we got to come up with a Christian boy band to go along with the big, huge boy band craze of NSYNC and Backstreet.
Plus One was crazy as far as the size. They were on, I remember they were on Lunchables.
What?
They got their face on Lunchables. Like, so they broke out in the mainstream. Their first album
Lunchables?
Was 2000. Yeah, and then their second album was 2002, and that's the album that really...
Obvious?
Yeah, so you had, like, Camouflage, Use Me, Let Me Be the One.
Use Me.
But what's interesting is on Spotify, none of these songs are in the top, the top. What is this force around? So this is kind of where they took the production up. Kind of here they got a little bit more money on the studio version. They got a little more attitude.
It was great.
This was our answer to, you know, to Backstreet Boys and to NSYNC.
Well, not our answer, but our Christian music.
Oh, no, we started Plus One.
Oh, we did?
Yeah.
Hey, fun fact, I tried to start a Christian boy band.
Yeah?
I did. In the early 2000s.
Did it go anywhere?
No. If we can count Newsboys, I'm a massive fan of their 90s, early 2000s work, Mary says.
Remember the song Going Crazy by
yes,
Plus One?
Yes,
this was one of my favorites.
Yes. Crazy. The vision gets hard to
find. I love the chorus on the song. I just have to wait for it for just a second.
What was my band called? What was it called?
I mean, it's a great song.
All these lyrics still live in here.
This is a great album.
Because my life is recording.
Plus One kind of went on to record one of my favorite Christmas albums that I completely forgot about. Remember the Christmas album? We talked about it a couple days ago.
Yeah.
Their Christmas album in 2002. I should say Christmas album again.
I won't forget this Christmas.
It was great. But this Christmas, one of the best
I don't think I remember this song.
Sure you do. Let's see. Let's fast forward here to the middle.
Yeah, let's do it. What are your favorite pop groups from the past?
Did you ever think of your name?
No, I forgot. Probably Cross Trainers.
Did you have any water references?
Always.
Remember this?
Yeah. Yeah, I remember.
So good. It's good.
So good. Who else? There were others. It wasn't just Plus One. Of course, they had another album, Exodus, which was great. Way different direction. They were called Plus One. They started losing a bunch of members at that time. So they were really actually minus two at that point. But Exodus is seriously one of my favorite albums of theirs.
Yeah, what do you like on that?
Outlaw. Outlaw. Absolutely.
We'll go to the right
here. So it. Good. This was 2003. This is the end of the boy band. Yeah. Yes.
Oh, yeah. Great. Hey, Tabitha. Good to see you again.
Oh, you got to the bridge.
Sorry.
That's okay. It's anyway, really good.
We'll listen to the background.
Yeah. But there are others. It's not just Plus One. They were the first ones, like, really in the boy band pop. But pop's been part of Christian music, I mean, ever since we got out of the Jesus movement, yeah. Really.
So this was part of Plus One was part of Capitol.
Okay.
So Provident Label
at first, then they switched over to Fairfair.
Yes. Yeah. Provident Label wanted to kind of get in the mix as well, and their answer was True Vibe.
True Vibe was Provident?
It was.
How funny.
Yep.
Wait, here it comes. Wait.
Oh,
wait.
You want it up?
Yes. It's the best part.
Here
it comes.
Build.
Feel the build? It needs a good, like, techno, like, remix.
Great. So that was 2003 and the end of Plus One. We never heard from them again.
Actually, we did hear from them again.
Oh, you want to tell the story?
This is a terrible, terrible story of woe. Any of you guys remember they're trying to make a comeback like 2 years ago?
Yeah.
And they like released a song called My All, which was way AC. I mean, it was like after Exodus, they went this creative direction. They were right back in the mix of trying to get a radio single. Then that's it. Nothing happened. No album.
I don't understand what happened there. That was the most craziest artist experience we've ever had.
I will reserve my comments further.
So, I'll say it.
Let's just say we had an interview, and it never saw the light of day.
No.
Hey, if enough of you share this video, maybe I'll go and find it. I mean, what do we have to lose? I can just publish it.
There you go. So, this is True Vibe. They had two albums. Of course,
they did.
2001, and then they followed up 2002, and then we never heard from them.
Now and Forever is their jam.
Do boy bands just have the kiss of death? If you're a boy band,
well,
you probably
deal.
Know you got about a 3-year window.
That's not true. What about One Direction, man?
I'll split up.
Well, yeah. I mean, right. But, true, I mean, 2001 was, like, the apex, and then it really felt like after 9/11, honestly, pop bands just kind of went away, and it was rock, and it was deep, like, introspective singer-songwriter stuff. I mean, it's come back, obviously, since then, but it was like 98 to 2001 was the sweet spot of...
It does seem to be coming back. You got 3 for 3, OBB.
Yeah.
What other
pop bands?
Pop bands currently that you guys
boy bands. Are there any Christian boy bands nowadays?
Oh, yeah. Anyway, so that's a.
Oh, see the light. Yeah, their True Vibe's second one was a lot more contemporary AC, you know, style. It was a lot less pop and more. Oh, we gotta get a radio single.
Right.
It's not just boy bands though. There was a little pop singer by the name of
Stacy Rico.
Yes.
Now this album hit in 2000.
Stacy Rico fans out there.
2000. So she was actually before True Vibe, and she was another artist that just exploded. I remember being in a meeting. She was on Forefront Records.
I was blown away.
And they kinda, what happens is these bands get huge, and then they just don't know what to do with them. It seems like. But I remember her album Christmas Wish came out, and I ran a big promotion on Family Christian Stories about Christmas Wish.
Did
and
you?
We encouraged everybody to create their
own Christmas
own
Wish.
Christmas Wish.
Oh, list. What was yours?
I don't remember. Huh. I don't, a car.
Oh.
I go big. Go big or go home.
Yeah.
And I didn't get it. Oh. Santa's stingy.
Yeah.
But
nobody else got their wish either. But it was a fun promotion. But
yeah, and then we went and bought like 20 people their Christmas album wish list.
Whoa, you
so
did?
It was kind of fun. Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah, we had hundreds and hundreds
cool.
of Christmas. So it was fun.
That would have gone viral had
but it was a
media
partnership
existed.
With the label. So, but since it's Christmas, let's listen to one of hers.
Okay.
Christmas Wish was kind of the big one, wasn't it?
Amanda says Anthem Lights is probably one of the biggest present day boy
bands.
Oh,
there you go. She's not wrong.
I don't even know this.
One of the best female vocalists, I think,
ever.
The past 20 years.
Ever in Christian music.
Ever?
Absolutely. No question.
Really?
In Christian music? Ever.
Wow.
Yes.
I'm going to have to think about that.
Yes. No question.
Okay, there you go. What was your big... Do you have a Stacey Rico memory? Did you ever see her live?
No.
I never saw her live either.
Nope. Her memory... A memory? I think I got... I heard her first on like a sampler that they used to give out at concerts and creation and stuff.
Right.
And I played it and it was like, wow, that's amazing.
Yeah.
She stood right up against everything else that was on the radio. And she made it on the radio, actually. She made it on top 40.
So
with this
Rico
song?
Was
it this song?
Huge in Japan.
Really?
Yes. In fact, she's got a whole Japan single, I think.
Is it in Japanese?
I think,
that'd be amazing.
Yeah, I think it is. I'm not finding it on here, though.
Didn't we just talk to our friend Derek about Stacey, and she's, like doing missions work and stuff?
Yeah, we have a friend who actually worked with Stacey, like, 10 years ago.
Yeah.
And she's not in music anymore.
Not at all.
Which is too bad.
Anybody know the song?
There's gotta be more.
Give a like if you know the song.
So the other big one that she had was a song called Stuck.
Really?
That's the number one song.
Yeah.
Well, it's number two song on Spotify.
I thought Don't Look at Me was... That was her breakout single.
Yeah.
But did she do well on radio?
Yeah.
There's a thumbs up.
Yeah, she did good.
Hey, you guys out there, hit us up with your favorite pop band. We'll stop what we're doing and play your stuff. So let us know your favorite throwback. And that could even be like 3 or 4 years ago.
Okay.
You know,
we got a couple more. We've got a couple more minutes left, so we're gonna blow through our list here.
Yes,
but we've got the other big female artist who was always in a girl fight with Stacey Rico.
Not true.
Oh, okay.
Not true. You're thinking of Britney and
right
and Christina. Zoe girl. Amanda said Zoe girl.
That is on our list. Is Rachel Lambeau.
Rachel.
Rachel's still doing music. Not a
she
lot.
She is. She's actually touring with Hozier.
What?
Yep.
Really?
She's one of the vocalists in the band Hozier.
Wow.
True story.
Here's a debate question for you.
Hokey.
Rachel Lampa vocals or Stacey Rico vocals?
That's tough. Let's listen and remind ourselves. Zoe Girl was Mary's jam. Hey, whoa. Mary liked Zoe Girl.
What?
She just admitted this publicly.
Wow.
That's why she likes 1GN.
She didn't have a lot of options back then.
I'm just saying. That's why she likes 1GN now.
This was Rachel Lampa's big. And she was on Word Records. And Nicole C. Mullen was really big at the time. And they had a lot of success with Nicole C. Mullen's ballads. And then Rachel Lampa came out. And I remember being in the meeting going, okay, this girl's 15 years old.
Yeah.
She needs to have a lot more fun. Like, this album was very
way heavy.
A lot of these big...
That's what Stacey did better with.
Yes.
I think Stacey's vocals are better.
And so, they did not do that. They kind of kept Rachel Lampa in this weird adult contemporary zone until the third album, Blur.
Brand New Life?
But
was that
of course,
it?
That was a remix album.
Oh. Here, go down. There's a song... Oh, it is Blessed. That's what you're playing. Yeah.
There's Live For You.
Yes, that one, Live For You. That was the first one I heard of her, and I thought it was incredible. Michael says, Big Daddy Weave is about as pop as I've ever listened to.
Well,
way to go. Everyone's got to take their steps in pop world. But Cutlass started hard, and now sounds a little poppy. We call them cuddles. Because they're a little cuddlier than they were back
in
the
last album. They kind of lost their edge a little bit, but...
The last album, yeah, they got a little
bit. They were also chasing... Well, I won't say that.
Well, you know, I mean...
They were chasing radio.
Well, and their ethos changed towards more worship. This is a good song. Let's go to Zoe Girl.
Okay.
And that was Live For You by Rich Hayao. Rich Hayao.
But I can't say enough about her 2011 album, All I Need, which was an independent album, and it was fantastic.
All We Need. In case you're looking it up. Zoe Girl had, is it I Believe? Was that their big one? Oh, you're on their profile. Here, go back. I live for you. Dude.
It's not working.
Back. But
there you go.
You know. So I Believe is their big jam.
Zoe Girl. Now this was this was Mary's band, huh?
And it's Jamie Grace's band. When we interviewed her, that's like one of the first names she always throws out as a big influence on her.
Zoe Girl. Great.
I heard rumors they're coming back.
No way.
Yep. Yeah, good song.
Now when did they? So they had a lot of greatest hits albums. So 2005.
Thumbs up this if you've heard it, if you like it.
The different kind of free album was great. The blue one. Beautiful Name, remember that song?
Nope. There's some hearts and thumbses. Yeah, come on, people. A little Zoe Girl love, what do we got here?
This is the last album we'll play and talk about, and then we'll just go through our list.
This one. Oh. You gotta play that.
Okay.
I mean, we would be remiss if we didn't miss. I mean, if we didn't play.
Hold on, you don't know the song?
Yeah.
They added some rock.
Tabitha said, I love True Vibe. Yep. I'm with you. So we go Dismissed. Yes, Dismissed. That was a good one. Because there was a TV show at that time called Dismissed. It was like a dating show on MTV that they wrote it based on.
Out of every album we've mentioned, I'm going to have to go back and listen to this one.
Yeah, we might be bumping kinda, that today.
Different kind of free album was great.
Plum?
I forgot that they were rock. Plum was always rock.
Not always.
More or less.
But back in that time, yes, they were.
Okay, so you want to go to...
Yes, this one. This was my guilty pleasure when it came out.
Now, I have a couple friends that I agree with in this area, and child singers, I can't do. Like kids.
They were
singers.
They were like the A-teens. You remember the A-teens, the ABBA-teens?
Yeah. Oh, my nails on the chalkboard.
Yeah, look at all these hearts. Come on, everybody. Jump 5. I'm a big fan. My wife is a big fan.
I could never get into it, but
so good.
That's okay.
Wait. You gotta get to the chorus.
Now they did they morph into Pure NRG or was that someone else?
Someone else. Different next generation. Wait. Look at all the hearts.
That's what it's like for me. Hey, but that's Jump 5. So Pure NRG was someone totally different. Okay, well there you go. Other kind of artists on our list were Avalon.
They were pop. Sorry, I know you think that they're contemporary. They were at their time.
They were
pushing the edges of pop, especially with their remix album.
Here's a little NRT trivia for you.
NRT
if it was
trivia.
Not for Avalon's O2 record, which is a remix pop record,
yes,
NRT wouldn't exist.
What?
Yeah. That's it.
Really?
It was actually in that marketing meeting. Some of you may have heard the story. It was actually in that marketing meeting where I came up with the idea for New Release Tuesday. So,
wow.
When I was working for Family Christian Store.
Because nobody knew when it was coming out, and that's what you were all brainstorming.
Yeah, there were like 80% of music fans have no idea when Avalon's releasing a new record. How do we tell them about this new O2 record?
Who were they signed with at the time?
That was Provident.
Yep. So there you go.
So there you go.
Yes, I liked Avalon. Love Jana's voice, yes.
And then Out of Eden was the other group that we came
up
with.
Yeah, absolutely.
And they were on Goatee.
Yep. They were. So they helped launch Goatee.
Yeah.
I think they were one of the original Goatee artists.
They were.
Yeah.
One Girl Nation, they're current. Yeah. Yep, they're current.
Well, no, they're 1GN now. They're not One Girl Nation now. Bought the album to give to my 2-year-old at the time. Something to listen to in my car besides Disciple to Cain Pillar. Actually, isn't half bad album.
No, it's really good. Is that their new one? Are you talking about their new one?
The new one or the first one? Which one? Well, he said 2 at the time, so it had to be the first one.
I can't do this.
So good. So good. There's so many good ones. And they had a lot of, like, Radio Disney play.
All
right,
well.
Jonah said, I'm sorry, I don't know those songs. I was little of those songs. 90s babies. Thanks for the fact and trivia. Well, now you know. Is it Joanna? Jonah?
That's why we do this.
Now you know. You can go back through your Spotify and listen and marvel.
There you go.
At the sounds.
If you guys come up with any other pop groups from way back when, post them in the comments. We'll read them later. We'll interact with you guys all day long as you watch.
All day.
Yes, all day.
Thanks for watching, as always. We're going to get on to the day and getting the site ready for another day of new releases that comes out tomorrow. There's a lot of stuff coming out tomorrow. And we will see you guys soon. So, Argentina. Hi, Claudio. Thanks for being here.
Go back and watch.
Yes.
We got to go.
We got to go.
But good seeing you.
Wait, can you put the song back on so we can...
You want Spin It Around?
Yeah, I do.
How about Beauty and the Beast?
No, that's not as good.
You want to Spin It Around again?
Yeah, I do.
Are you going to spin around in your chair while I leave?
Yeah, I think I will.
Okay, here. Wait, hold on. There you go.
This is the bridge.
Thank you guys for joining us on NRT Now. We'll see you Monday. Bye.